Don't forget, if you don't mind, sitting on this side of the house, in the sanctuary.
We don't mind.
So we don't look so empty on YouTube. If you do mind, that's okay.
Thank you.
avoid vertigo sitting on this side of the church, but it's hard. Good morning, Brother Al. Yes, we noticed that when we first came here, yeah. Even when we were sitting on the wrong side, or the former side.
The goats, instead of the sheep.
Yeah, take a while to get used to, but she does not seem to me to have given me that thought. I know very little, but I mean, she's not, from everything I understand, she's not a dummy.
Well, there are really great people that are
devoted
to
Trump. Angela, I don't know if I can handle this.
I know, I get vertigo here.
We're just holding the house for a couple of stragglers. Peace be with you. Good morning. I am so happy to see you here this morning on this cloudy, drizzly Sunday morning, but the temperature's not too cold. So we'll take it. We can still use a little bit more rain. I hope you are all feeling well and feeling excited about this week to come and all the blessings God's going to bestow upon us this week. I will admit to being a little tired. I struggled with this text this week. Pretty much every night I was tossing and turning trying to figure out, is it too late to change? Let's go do some happy Jesus stuff. I intended to put something in the e-blast and in the bulletin. I knew it when we had our staff meeting Wednesday. I said there was something I wanted to write for the e-blast, but I can't remember what it was. I remembered this morning. I wanted to put a trigger warning concerning the text today. And for some who have experienced some of the issues that are brought up in this text. And so this is October, this is Domestic Violence Month, I believe. And so it's a very difficult text. And I just wanna read a trigger warning that I got from some friends on Facebook. Today we continue our journey through the Old Testament using the narrative lectionary. We believe it is important to read stories from the Old Testament to connect with our ancestors in faith and hear about the ways that people have encountered God throughout history. We recognize the importance of tackling hard subjects and broken places in worship, realizing that difficult things are part of our story as community as well. We also acknowledge that these passages contain violent or disturbing material. Our scripture today from the story of King David, 2 Samuel 11 and 12, contains mentions of sexual assault, murder, and the traumatic death of an infant. We encourage all gathered here to engage with this story and the service in whatever way feels appropriate to you. I ask that we take a moment of silence for those voiceless victims and those who are suffering. Amen. Please rise as you are able and join us in our call to worship, gathering prayer, and opening hymn. God of salvation's joy, we gather to celebrate and revere you.
We come realizing that we are broken. Forgive and recreate us.
God of unfailing love, we gather to worship and honor you.
We come, and because of your compassion, forgive and renew us.
God of new beginnings, we gather to praise and thank you.
We come through your gracious mercy, forgive and restore us, so that with clean hearts we may truly worship you.
Pray with him. Beloved, holy lover, we come to you, to our house. Here we come to offer you our thanksgiving and praise in response to the abundance of your creation. Here we come to share with you our prayers, confession, and petition, for they lie heavy on our hearts, even knowing that we are here. We come along to hear you say, I am with you always. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. When Jesus comes back, he will bring to light the things now hidden in darkness and will disclose the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us join together and confess our sins. Please join me in our prayer of confession. Gracious God, our sins are too heavy to carry, too real to hide, and too deep to forgive what our lips tremble to name. From our hearts we no longer bear, and what has become of us, a consuming fire of judgment.
Set us free from the past that we cannot be changed.
Open us to a future in which we can be changed, and grant us grace to grow more and more. Amen.
Amen.
Psalms 103, 8 through 12 says, "You are tender and compassionate, Yahweh, slow to anger and always loving. Your indignation doesn't endure forever, and your anger lasts only for a short time. You never treat us as our sins deserve. You don't repay us in kind for the injustices we do. For as high as heaven is above the earth, so great is the love for those who revere you. As far away as the east is from the west, that's how far you remove our sins from us." Family, know then that God has heard your confessions and has forgiven and already forgotten your sins. Therefore, you are free to live and love as Christ taught us. Amen.
Amen.
And now, family, lean in as we listen for God's word.
Go off the board. David sent Joab out.
daughter of Leah, and the wife of Uriah the Hittite. Then David sent messengers together. She came to him, and he slept with her. Now she was purifying herself of her monthly uncleanliness. Then she went back home. The woman conceived and sent word to David saying, I am pregnant. Verses 26 to 27. When Uriah's wife heard that her husband was dead, she mourned for him. After the time of mourning was over, David had her brought to his house, and she became his wife and bore him a son. But the thing David had done displeased the Lord. 2 Samuel chapter 12, verses 1 through 9. The Lord sent Nathan to David. When he came to him, he said, there were two men in a certain town, one rich and the other poor. The rich man had a very large number of sheep and cattle. But the poor man had nothing except one little ewe lamb he had bought. He raised it, and it grew up with him and his children. It shared its food, drank from his cup, and even slept in his arms. It was like a daughter to him. Now a traveler came to the rich man, but the rich man refrained from taking one of his own sheep or cattle to prepare a meal for the traveler who had come to him. Instead, he took the ewe lamb that belonged to the poor man and prepared it for the one who had come to him. David burned with anger against the man and said to Nathan, as surely as the Lord lives, the man who did this must die. He must pay for that lamb four times over because he did such a thing and had no pity. Then Nathan said to David, you are the man. This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. I anointed you king over Israel, and I delivered you from the hand of Saul. I gave your master's house to you, and your master's wives into your arms. I gave you all Israel and Judah. And if all this had been too little, I would have given you even more. Why did you desire the word? Why did you despise the word of the Lord by doing what is evil in his eyes? You struck down Uriah the Hittite with the sword, and took his wife to be your own. You killed him with the sword of the Ammonites. And Psalm 51, verses 1 through 9. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your unfailing love, according to your great compassion. Blot out my transgression. Wash away all my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. You expect? They were violent people, and it was a violent time. Look at the
ritualistic requirements of her religion, both minding their own business when the lust and greed of David interrupted their lives and sent them on a different direction. We all of us face interruptions in our lives, and I'm sorry to tell you this if you didn't know it already. Messed up stuff happens all the time, and if it hasn't happened to you yet, keep on living it. If you are that victim, or if you are being victimized, I offer my prayers and will stand with you and will support you as you go through. Get some help. Protect yourself as best you can. Do what you need to do to survive, but hang in there. Keep the faith. It gets better. Okay, another confession here. Those words I just said, they felt so inadequate. I meant it, but you're going through and all I can do is offer platitudes. Does this really help? I gotta admit, it never worked for me when somebody said it. I appreciated it, and often I felt that it was. The real talk of the word didn't help. Not done that. He was an advisor to David. And now we respond. We respond with prayer. At this portion of our service, we lift up to God our joys, our concerns, our hopes, our dreams. We go to God in prayer. We see those listed in the bulletin, and now we offer you the opportunity to share with us, with your family, so that we may join you in prayer. For whom and for what shall we pray?
Prayers of healing for Tom as he struggles with cancer.
God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Chris.
For the children in our school districts, particularly our most vulnerable, and for the adults that tirelessly work to meet their needs.
Amen. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For my father, Glenn, who suffers from Parkinson's.
God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
A continuing prayer for the community, love and will to address the crisis and causes of urban violence plaguing our communities of color.
God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
I'd like to ask for prayers of comfort for the family of Nico Saracini, the young man who was killed in New Haven this week, and who was in my class, and for love and guidance as I try to help the students through this loss.
Amen. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Continuing prayers for Alita, my friend.
God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For everyone in the congregation who works so hard to keep our church afloat and working toward its mission, and especially for the members of the search committee as they continue to do a great deal of difficult work. Let us pray that their efforts will bear fruit.
God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Maybe a little bit lower in the suffering scale, but a prayer of healing for our daughter Miranda. This will put some of our minor troubles in perspective. She, her husband, and her two-year-old all have COVID, leaving only a five-year-old boy with unlimited energy and perhaps no supervision. So, prayer of healing for all.
God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And from online, prayer of healing and strength for Tatiana, Bernice, and the elderly in nursing homes and rehabs, and that's from Benjamin.
God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Continued prayer for all those who are claiming membership in this congregation and we don't see them. God bless them. And bring them home. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Then let us go to God in prayer. A few moments of silent prayer where we each reach into our own hearts and talk to God for ourselves. I will come in with a few words, and we will close with the Lord's Prayer with trespasses. Let us pray. Walk with us, Lord. Clearly, we don't know the direction. We don't know the path. All we know is that we are heading to you, to the comfort and the warmth of your embrace. Help us to get there, Lord. We are so full of evil and sins and selfishness and self-centeredness that we often fall away and fail. We need you to grab us, Lord. Be our friend. Be our guide. And walk with us. You've heard our prayers, O God. Those we spoke. Those we hold deep in our hearts. God, we bring them to you. We bring them to you because you told us to. We bring them to you because we know that only you can fix them. So God, we come to you with open hearts, admitting our frailty, accepting that we need you. Continue to bless us, O God. Continue to love us. Continue to walk with us. We close this prayer today, gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, praying the words that Jesus taught us. Our God,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And now let's take a few moments. I'm not even going to say a few moments again. And pass the peace of Christ to your family.
Peace be with you, Jeannie.
Peace.
Peace.
And peace be with you.
Peace,
Jane.
Peace,
Timothy.
Deuces to all of you in YouTube land. Peace of Christ be with you. I actually heard them say also with you. That's pretty cool. Are there any announcements? Please make your way forward. I know there should be a couple. As we settle from sharing the peace and love of Christ, hopefully with plans to gather together again soon, so that y'all can really get some loving and peacing going on. That's what we do as family. And please govern yourselves, or please hear our announcements. Govern yourselves after you hear.
Tonight from 4 to 6, Oasis will meet at Spring Glen Church for a chill night. And then next Sunday from 4 to 6, it will be at North Haven Congregational for a Halloween party. And that is for Tide Pool and Oasis. And there will be costume contests and creepy activities. So get ready.
Next Saturday is the day we clean the green. If anyone would like to help with that, you only need to remember to wear a closed shoe, no sandals, and you'll be provided with gloves and whatever you call that thing that picks things up from the ground. Oh, 10 o'clock Saturday morning. We meet over at Trinity Episcopal Church.
Good morning. Today is October 23rd, and what that means is that today is the Connect Candidate Assembly. The event will be held today at 3 p.m. at Congregation B'nai Israel, which is located at 2710 Park Avenue in Bridgeport, but it will also be held on Zoom. I'm not sure, can I see a show of hands? Does anyone plan to attend in person today? In person, great. A couple of us, so find me there. And how many people have registered to attend on Zoom? Excellent. All right, this is a great opportunity for us to show our legislatures, our strength and our numbers as Connect moves forward with initiatives in justice reform, mental health resources, and education funding. So it's not too late to register. Feel free to click the link in the e-blast and register, and keep an eye on your email for a link to the Zoom meeting at 3. So as many of you who could attend, that would be great. Thank you.
Although it's still October, we need to look ahead to Thanksgiving. And in our e-blast this week was the link to information from the Downtown Evening Soup Kitchen about how we can help them in providing meals to people around the area. They expect to deliver at least 850 meals to those in need this Thanksgiving. And there is a shopping list of things they can use. I have printed it off because I'm a paper person, and I will post it on the bulletin board in the lobby.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Al Farino, the moderator here at United Church on the Green, and I just want to welcome all of you. We know that you have many choices as to how to spend your Sunday morning, so we're especially grateful that you chose to spend it with your church family here at United Church on the Green or on YouTube. I'd like to invite all of you to stay for a time of coffee and cookies and cake and conversation following church today out in the narthex, and if it's not raining yet, possibly outside. We can take stuff out there and show the people on the green that we're here and that they're welcome here. And please, if you're watching on Zoom, on YouTube, please turn over to Zoom so you can join us on the Zoom coffee hour. I want to remind everybody that next week, after the service, we'll be having our annual autumnal congregational meeting, at which time we will be, among other things, voting on the new constitution and bylaw amendments, and also discussing various things. I'm told that one of the things that people would like to talk about is the time that we actually start the service, so please bring your thoughts to that. Whether we stay at 10 o'clock or 10:30, 10:15, 10:12, who knows? That's about it. So please, I urge everyone, if you can, to come in person next week, or to, we'll be doing, providing the congregational meeting via Zoom for people who cannot make it. Thank you.
Hi, good morning. I'm sure many of you know I'm Scott Hawkins. Usually I'm sitting in the back reading the prayer requests that come in from YouTube. As you know, we are now offering a hybrid service. We're continuing the YouTube streaming, and we have a production team that does that. And if you're interested in getting involved with the whole production end of that and supporting our growing use of multimedia platforms and want to become a digital deacon, please join me on any Sunday in the back. Carrie's back there today learning how to become a digital deacon. I promise you, if I can do it, it is not a heavy lift. But it is, you know, a place to sit back there and reading prayer requests. But on any Sunday, feel free to sit back there, and I'll gladly show you what to do, where everything is, and how easy of a job it is to be involved with our video productions. That's it. Thank you.
I feel like getting up. Let's give it up for Scott Hawkins, everybody. Let's give it up. You don't want to announce the Corinthians?
Oh. You're talking about the faith formation?
Yeah. Hang on, one more. I'll just say that the Connect, that's one way we become Nathans. That's when we have the powers that be and the powers that want to be on a stage, and we can tell them what we're looking for, what we expect from them, and then hold them accountable. So if you can't make it to that Connect meeting, come, be a part of it.
So good morning, I'm John Blue. I didn't bring my calendar, and I hadn't expected to announce this for a week or two, but I'm part of the faith, I guess it's called the Faith Formation Ministry Team. I still think of it as a committee. And we've been talking about what to do with our next presentation or offering to the congregation. We've been a little discommoded just by the fact that we haven't had the Bradley Room. And we're not going to have the Bradley Room for a few months, but we're going to try to do something to try to educate the congregation and ourselves more about the Bible, about Christianity, about the church. And we decided at our last meeting that what we want to do is devote three Sundays in terms of after church discussion to 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians is kind of the most famous book in the Bible, other than maybe Psalm 23, because 1 Corinthians 13 is read at almost every wedding and funeral you can imagine, and it's certainly an amazingly beautiful passage. But there's a lot more to 1 Corinthians. That some of it is really interesting, some of it is head-scratching, some of it is pretty appalling. But if we can do David and Bathsheba, we can certainly do Paul. So I don't have my calendar, but we're going to do it over three Sundays, the two Sundays preceding Thanksgiving, and then I think it's December 4th, which whatever is the Sunday following Thanksgiving. And I'll try to have those precise dates for you in the next week or two, but you can look at your calendar. I think 1 Corinthians is 16 chapters. It's about 12 or 13 pages in the Pew Bible. I should say that as the last one out in the stampede, I was chosen as the facilitator, which means we're all in trouble. But I think we'll probably divide it up into thirds, do the first five chapters the first Sunday, the middle five chapters the next Sunday, and after Thanksgiving we'll do the last six chapters. It's a book that repays much rereading, and it's probably not too early to start. So we'll talk more about this next month. Thank you.
Sorry, I was checking text because I was reporting that the live stream audio had issues. So hopefully y'all heard everything. If not, we'll do service over. And now we reach the moment where we ask you to participate in the service through your giving. We ordinarily, or we used to back in the olden days before COVID, would ask you to walk up and place your gifts, your tithes, your offerings in the basket. We don't do that anymore yet, but we still ask that you give. There's a basket in the back if you'd like to leave a check or money order or cash. Do they still do money orders? Or cash. There's a square somewhere around here that you might be able to use with a credit card, or you can just do it online. And our website are following the QR code in our bulletin. Your gifts help us to be Nathans. Your gifts help us to do the work and help the people that need the help. So we ask that you give generously. Give as God has blessed you, knowing that as you give, you are blessing someone else, and God will multiply blessings back to you. I still remember that old evangelist when I was a kid said, I serve God on a money-back guarantee. You give money, God's going to give you money back, I guarantee. You don't plant tomatoes and expect grapes, so if you're planting cash, God gonna bless you with cash. I like that at work. She used to get big offerings. Caesar. Please join me in our prayer of dedication and thanksgiving. Generous God, we have known your unfailing love and faithfulness, your care and provision, your protection and salvation. And so we respond to deep gratitude, offering back to you a portion of what you have given us. Accept the gifts we bring, tangible expressions of our love and gratitude for what you have so generously given to us.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated. I'm sorry, don't be seated. We got a hymn. As we are sent out to do the work of God. Amen. You may be seated. So if you can continue on with the story of David, you would see that Uriah probably got a hero's funeral. Bathsheba and Nathan plotted together to get Bathsheba's son Solomon into the kingship. And she lived out her life in luxury as the queen mother. And until Solomon came of age, she had a whole lot of control of running the kingdom of Israel. And David died betrayed by one of his friends alone. So.
Happy Sunday.
There was a little cut up, comeuppance. It's a horrible story. It's a horrible story any way you look at it, for a number of reasons, more than just the assault, but for a number of things. Just the way that they talk about people. It's a horrible story. But it's very real. And I'm sad to say a lot of our faith, the faith that we practice as Christianity, is built off of some of these stories. Actually, it's built off of most of these stories. But if we stick around and keep going through this story of this family, you're going to find out that a lot of what Jesus was against is this stuff. It's all of this stuff. That's what we're getting towards. This stuff that we've built our faith on. Jesus said, that ain't it. That ain't it. Just love. So, while we wait for Jesus, come somewhere around Christmas, let us be Nathans. Let us stand up for justice. Let us not be afraid to speak up, to speak out, to call wrong, wrong. Speak truth to power? Okay. Speak truth. That's your power. Don't worry about the repercussions. You will get a hero's funeral. Or you'll live a life of luxury as the Queen Mother. God bless you. God keep you. Go do something good. Amen.
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 Thank you.
I was in Battelle Chapel in 1985 when Charles preached on the first time.
Yeah. How many people were there?
It was an evening concert. Yeah. And it was close to packed.
Wow.
It wasn't for a regular church service.
Yeah,
it was
yeah,
a Bud Valley evening concert. And I remember Gene was sick. We had a neighbor who